Good evening and welcome to the most populous black nation of the world. Of course, it is Nigeria, where volley excellence is on the platter. For the very first phase of the National Division 1 Volleyball League, Abuja 2022 is what we have on the floor. It is inside the indoor sports hall, Packet B, MKO Abuja National Stadium, where we have been enjoying for the last 5 days for volley excellence and the very best in the men and women category with a marriage of grassroots and professional volley. Welcome. I'm your commentator right here. Sean Pablo is my name. Well, I've got George Malaika for the analysis.
Yeah, it's good to be back again in this beautiful afternoon. It is the Nigeria National Division 1 Volleyball right here in the commentary box.
And it is between two teams who continue to seek their first win in the tournament. It will be certainly one team will be on top of the other. The two teams have actually played twice and they've lost twice. Here is going to be third game for both of them. Well, they produce very young sides here. Of course, let's get you into the team list and let you know who are on the court. Between bayonet spikers playing from left to right, with purple, white over black, against Anambra Queens playing from right to left, and it's all pink over purple for them. Well, at the moment it is 1 point apiece. Well, let's get you into how they start the game for the fifth match of match day 5. Well, starting in position number 1 for Bayonet is jersey number 9, Joseph Comfort, the captain of the side. In position number 2 is Peter Judith, jersey number 6. Number 2 is in position number 3, Bature Charity. Number 8 is in position number 4, and she is Adisa Khadijat. Number 7 is in position number 5, Luca Godia. Why, jersey number 10, Jonah Roos, is in position number 6. To wrap up their substitution, we have jersey number 3, Joshua Betsheba. Number 4, Ibireri Efe Patience. 5, Sandra Sarah. There is 11, Adelike Blessing. 12, Oyegu Constance. 13, Paul Deborah. And 14, Kajeri Victoria. The officials of the team remain head coach Emmanuel Yahaya. And the assistant is Kanga Emmanuel. And for the team who are with the lead right here, Anambra Queens starting in position number 1, jersey number 4, Nkwo Chinemere. Number 2 position is jersey number 2, Chukwuka Oluebube. Playing number 3 position, number 9, Manafa Ngozi. Number 5 spots, number 4 position, the captain of the side, Okafor Chika. And in number 5 position, number 10, Ezogu Ujunwa. In number 6 position is jersey number 11, Edoche Ogadema. In the reserve for the team, we have jersey number 3, Ezechukwu Chinelo. We have number 6, Ozuebunam Cynthia. There is number 7, Onye Chiamaka. 8, Udagbala Ifunaya. We also have jersey number 12, Paul Martha, and the liberal, the only liberal of the side, Nwankwo Ogechukwu. The head coach for Anambra Queens remain Okafor Uchenna Solomon, assisted by Oti Stella. The medical is Ata Akachika. The Queens lead by 5-2. The women are fair today's game, and the very first referee of the game as well, a lady who stands tall amongst men. First referee, Antonia Johanna, assisted by Joseph Obarian. Both referees are grade 2 nationally badged The reserve referee is Blessing Godwin, while the scorer is Stella Ajilore, assisted by Christiana Sule. Line one is Esther Aimila, and line three is manned by Bosari Abdul Latif. We are in the technical hands of the technical director, Martins Melandi, and the Nigeria Volleyball Referees Association is rarely represented by
Madam Sheba
Jefferson. Rally in progress. Of course, the night one about to come upon us. But after eight, the leadership of four, as 6 points have been won by the youngest side in the tournament. And they make it even better point, making 7-2 come to reality after the night rally. Well, before this game, George, the two teams here have not won a game. And as a matter of fact, they haven't won a set. Obviously, one is going to win. Who do you fancy?
Before the beginning of the match, I was thinking Bayonets are going to be the dominant force in this match. But the way the thing is going, I don't even seem to understand what the Bayonets are doing. So it's eventually a match of two equal sides. We are going to be staying here for a longer time than any other match we'll be staying right now in this place. They are going to be having very long rallies before a point is going to be made. So the game will just keep, the tide will just keep changing. To get to a time you get to see Bayern will keep making the point, and it will also be a time where you see the Anambra Queens keep making the point. But I just hope that in the end one team will be able to win by 3-0. But if not, we are going to stay here for a longer time.
How long now, as they get back to winning ways, having won the last rally to get them back to a 4-point lead. It used to be 7-3. It is 8-4. And they still lead in the game. Well, they might be the underdogs, but of course you cannot take away the zeal power. It's always about who wants it more. It's about the hunger. It's about experience of Bayonet against the youthfulness of the Queens. About it, just as Joe says, could be back and forth situation before we get a settle for who takes the day. It could be a 5-set thriller. Well, the inexperience in the team is beginning to wade in, as we now saw two players moving away from the ball when both of them are even supposed to attack the ball, or perhaps have a good concentration with the right communication as well, having one go for it and the other ready for a set. But they only lead by 2 points now, haven't gone up by 4-6-8. Anambra Queens are still in charge, however. Now making 9 to open up a 3-point lead. We have been here before. We've even gone past it by a point for Anambra Queens. It's a good set. And it drops perfectly. It's a cross spike that went all the way from the fourth position down to the fifth position of Anambra Queens, and there was just no one at the end of it. How do you position yourself when you're supposed to know your position from the start of the game?
Yeah, that is one beauty of volleyball. Sometimes the back players do not always seem to have a permanent position. It depends on what's happening with the ball. The ball might rotate and bring players back and forth, side to side. But what happened right there, the player on position 5, she went forward to dig the ball across the net, but before she goes back there, the ball was sent back to her position. She was not there, so the ball eventually falls to the floor. But if you really want to keep that in check, you need to do everything on court as quickly as possible, because you have an area of coverage.
Doing it as quickly as possible, and also talking about coverage, A team can only cover themselves by themselves when rotation is the rule of the game. Which totally means if I am moving to position number two from number five spot, definitely I expect someone to be in my position so as to watch my back. Isn't that what the game is about?
Well, seeing a player from position five go as far as position two, that would be too adventurous. The audacity would be too long, but for instance,
that was what she did, wasn't it?
What she did was that she came close to position four to help out with anticipating a drop, and eventually the ball caught her while moving, so she just had to cross the ball back. So before she goes back, the ball is now back to her position. But regardless, the player in position five was supposed to, in position six was supposed to be mindful of her leaving that particular position. The player on position she would have actually made that effort to cover that spot.
Well, if you are just coming new to the sport of volleyball, you realize that we have been talking about some kind of numbers. Well, it is not about the numbers on the jerseys of the players. It is the numbers on the team. I'll talk about what the court presents. There are dominant six positions in volleyball. Always we have two sides of the court, the front row and the back row, where three players always man each of the rows. Well, from the behind, we have positions like number one, number six, and number five. And again, in front, we have two, three, four. A great libero job there being done by the libero of Anambra Queens. The only they have. One call Gechuku there, but finally, it's going to be an upturn now as experience is beginning to pay more. Well, you say 9-11 or 11-9, it is Bayonet you have to talk about. They lead here by two. Too long. Won't cause any havoc from Peter Judith. And they find a point. And one closer as well. Anambra Queens 10, Bayonet Spikers 11. It's the first set in this game already. 12 minutes, 27 seconds on the clock. We could stay here for hours. As both teams are searching for it. They know that both of them sit at the bottom of the log in the women category. Oh, that's a great spike from Udagbala Ifunanya. And we'll come back to where we started. After 22 rallies, it's 11 apiece.
Yeah, it is 11 apiece, like I said earlier on. We are going to witness a very long match. In this match, I am just hoping that possibly one team is going to win by three sets or at most 3-1. But 3-0 will be a little bit better for the sake of all of us, for the sake of time. Because I tell you, you keep seeing this thing happen. You see, the tides will always be in one side before you know it will change to the other side. That is how they will keep playing to the end of this match. And that will eventually make this match too long for all of us. But however, the match is getting exciting and interesting gradually.
Of course, growing in momentum. It used to be 9-11. It is now 11-13, or better still, 13-11, which totally means that Anambra Queens have gained the last four rallies, leaving Bayonet Spikers where they've been in the last five. And leading by two, haven't gone down by two, is a reality for the team from southeastern Nigeria. Oh, the struggle for that one. But it is Bayonet who gets it. And the captain as well, Joseph Comfort. But a quick substitution now, the libero goes out. Joshua Basheba for Bayonet Spikers. Goes out in place for Sanda Sera. Left fist from Joseph Comfort. And it's a Joseph Comfort locking. I mean, I can understand the positional play from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, but when you find the ball coming right in front of you, what are you meant to do, George?
What really happened was that was Ifunaya. She's one of the players that hit a bit hard and strong on this particular match. So the player right there in position four, at the point she thought Ifunaya was going to have a strong hit on the ball, but as Ifunaya jumped, she got to drop the ball. That was why she couldn't defend that ball.
Well, it was Joseph Comfort, the captain of Bayonet Spikers, who couldn't defend the ball. Well, she was caught watching, and they will now return to their bench for a little bit of some quick pep talk for the timeout as they take a 3-point deficit to it. Bayonet Spikers here trailing 12-15 to Anambra Queens. Rallies, 3 the difference. Still the first in the fifth game on the fifth day of the first phase 2022 National Division 1 Volleyball League. Abuja 2022 it is. It is in the indoor portal, Packet B, MKO Abiola National Stadium. It's a big spike that there by the same lady, Udiagbalami Funaya. Now she can begin to be a characteristic for her team. I mean, bring the kind of characters, bring the kind of charisma, be the kind of leader that they will actually need to pull one forward, at least to get a win in this.
Yeah, that is what she's supposed to be doing like long ago. If the coach really want to see his, if the Anambra Queens coach really want to see his side have an edge over this match, he will need to tell Ifunaya never to have the ball. And she need to hit the ball with all her strength. If keeps doing that, the Bayonet team will eventually lose confidence, and they'll just keep seeing ball falling to the floor. But if Ifunaya keep dropping the ball, just to play exactly the kind of style the Bayonet plays, the match will make it becomes more difficult, and even instruction given will not really be taken. But if Ifunaya can continue hitting the ball just the way she has done, I think this match is already over.
Well, we just got started, and it's just the very first 30 rallies we'll see in it. We're still expecting the very first win, as we are in the first set of it. And Ifunaya had another point for them. Anambra have an edge of 4 points, and Joseph Comfort only had to escort the ball, and that was all she did.
Yeah, she had to escort the ball. She had no chance of retrieving back that ball because the ball is already going outside. But if the player that had the touch on that ball, if the ball was high enough, she would have had a chance, but it was so low and it was just flying outside.
Well, it went away, and it went away from Bayonet as they are now away by 6 points. Anambra Queens are really trying to get the first set in the tournament. Both teams haven't won a set in the tournament yet, but of course, well, there will be winners here. It's a big spike. Well, he put in check by Bayonet. And it is Ifunaya again with a big hit. Well, when you say big materials that come in small packages, that is exactly what you get from Udebayan there. Maximum respect from how she hits the ball with the intention. She goes high, she should hit harder. That's exactly what Joe said, expecting Coach Okafor Uchenna Solomon to let her know about it. But of course, you can tell that she can even go harder. But they drop 2 points, and the lead of 6 becomes 4. And it is Bayonet who have gained the last 2 points. Oh, but that one is far away. Joseph Comfort really taking so much on her shoulders. Being one player, very active for Barnet in the game. And it's been all tournament long. Against is there to make the bump.
Well, we continue to talk about minimizing unforced errors, and this can actually play a huge role when you play an underdog side. You are not supposed to give away when you're supposed to keep to yourself. Now, we continue to see Bayonet spikers make...
That wouldn't help them to survive this game. If the Bayonet also want to stay in this match as contenders, they also need to... One or two players amongst them also need to come out and begin to hit the ball with brute. But all they keep doing is the ball back to the Anambra Queens court. And the Anambra Queens court, they have one or two players that actually hit the ball that hard. You could see Uju also attempt to always hit the ball hard. You could see if Naya. So, you see? Now, that is also a bad reception. And the setter was nowhere to set the ball. And no player was there to defend that, to retrieve that ball back up. So, if the Bayonet Spikers really wants to win this game, they need to start playing some volley excellence.
Well, that's what we live for. That's what we're here for. Vast Vest of Volley Excellence. Joseph Comfort. Oh, poor fist from Udagbalai Funaya. And she feels bad about it. She's still manning her number one position. But they lead here by 6 again. Could have been 8. Used to be 7. It needs 3, half of their leadership to make it a first set in the kitty in the tournament. The rally continues to be in progress as the point is being played for. Welly, and there's a spike, but it's too much of an energy. Ejeogu Junwa unable to put that ball within the lines. It's a good service. And it's a good ball as well. They were totally displaced and they were caught napping. Great block, the right place at the right time. They're still in charge of trying to get that point that gets them closer to it. But Bayonet Spikers have got a statement here before that could happen. Prolonging the rally, tries to put a drop shot there, but it won't happen. Goes out of the line. Joseph Comfort, one of the best outside hitters we have in the tournament. Number 9 for Bayonet Spikers. Really would not like the fact that they are down here or that they are about to drop this set. So it will be about how they respond. Good spike from Funaya. Anytime she comes to the ball, there is always danger lurking around. Another great spike. It was, and they get that point. Manafang Gozi, and that it's now set point for Anambra Queens for the very first time in this tournament. It only took 3 games before they get here, but they're here finally. It just might take it with just one hit if we get an ace from the service. Will not be an ace, but rally is still in progress. And they are still in charge of it. Oh, great block. A Bireri, if a patience, really. Knew just what to do.
She did it all right, and they are still in this set. Good service from Adeleke Blessing. And Anambra Queens are trying to be quite cautious here, not to throw away what they think they've gotten, but you've got to put much more energy. That is an outside hitter that hits with the right venom to get the right point as they now get to the mark of 20 themselves. Bayonet Spikers jersey number 9, Joseph Comfort. But it's not comfortable yet for them, as a miss of a hit could be enough for Anambra Queens to get the set. When we come back, we'll find out. We are back, and the game continues, and it is Bayonet Spikers who takes us to it. And I said earlier, just one hit could be just enough for Anambra Queens to claim their first set, and they didn't even have to pull a muscle.
Yeah, I saw it. By the time that timeout call was made, I just knew it, that the Bayonet Spikers were going to serve outside.
You must be a magician. We'll be right back. What we do is going to be the very second set in match number 5 of match day 5 between Anambra Queens, who head up for the very first set in of the tournament for them, 25-20. They wrapped it up against Bayonet Spikers. We'll come back here. It will be the second set.
Thank you.
is if the Bayonet Spikers also utilize their own balls, if they keep having a good set and a good and a hard spike, they might stand a chance to win a set in this match. If they don't, they stand to lose by 3 in this match.
Well, talk about youthfulness. The young side actually got the first set. But it's not about starting with the right energy. It's about maintaining the momentum of the same energy, the same level of it. And when you need that to be done, you have to request from the Anambra Queens, jersey number 8, Udagbalami Funaya. She's always going to be doing that all night long, every time she gets the chance to do it. And she will bring them back to where we started after two rallies in set number 2. It is one apiece. Charity Bature. And she puts it to the backcourt, but it's Wally put in place. Joseph Comfort with a spike that wasn't too huge, but it's enough to put a number of spikers, a number of queens, I beg your pardon. Oh, and she will be the one to conclude what she started. Joseph Comfort earlier was a huge spike that came from her. Then he had to take a tip from her to drop the shot down and get the second point for them inside the second set. They trailed by a set but lead by a point here. A good service from Joseph Comfort. And it will be another one from Udagbalam Ifunaya. Well, really, you see players come on the court and then they orchestrate the game. You really want to give kudos to the reading skills of Udagbalam Ifunaya. How she gets to read the game, how she gets to move, her ability to always be right there when the set is made. I think that's just impeccable.
Yeah, her mobility and anticipation is really, really impeccable. It's just that as it stands, she doesn't want to be consistent in hitting the ball. I was thinking the coach has already identified that and has already given the instruction for her to hit it to 90% of her balls. But I get to see her right now again, try to drop the ball, going back court, but the ball has been retrieved. But if you ask me anytime or always, I would tell you, if she continue to hit all the balls, they will have an easy win. You see, that's another hit. If she doesn't get the ball with a hard hit, she will make the Bayonet have a chase on the ball. And before you know it, they will just lose the ball.
And she will come another hit there, and that counts for point number 3. 3 points for Anambra Queens, 3 hits from Udagbalami Funaya. 3 points for Udagbalami Ifunaya. She continues to be absolutely consistent. That is the kind of class and quality you require of a player as young and dynamic. She can be a huge prospect, don't you see?
Yes, like I tell you, while I saw her play yesterday, I told you she is going to be a hit prospect. Give her 2-3 more years with hard work and dedication. Her determination will take her to places she doesn't even imagine. So I think she's a good prospect. She have a strong hit. She had a big lift. So what she really need to do now is to keep doing what she is doing with more determination and extra effort.
But from one side of the court to the other, Bayonet Spikers have quite made 2 rallies by picking them up to go up by 2 points as well. 5-3 in their favor, courtesy of Ebireri. Patience. Oh, but this time it's a poor hit from Adeleke Blessing. And that gives away a point cheaply. Service now. They have actually made 2 erroneous services in this second set, Anambra Queens. The ball looked totally out, and I think that's exactly what the coach was saying. Coach Okafor Uchenna Solomon, it was going out, you just let it roll back. That was all you should do.
Yeah, that ball was going right out, but because she was not in a proper position, she did not bend low or get ready to play the ball. So she was also to judge what's going to happen with the ball if you are in a volleyball court and you are not ready for a ball.
A poor bump this time. And they now open up a 3-point lead. Bayonet Spikers taking an advantage of mishandling of the ball. Oh, I thought that was poor. Couldn't even go past our own net. Well, you played the game, George Maleka, at some point. You want to start the game in the first set. You play in the second set. You don't even care about the time that you spend before a timeout. But then, at what point do you start getting weak arms?
That is one surprising thing a whole lot of people don't know about volleyball. You never ever get weak arms. It gets stronger and fierce as long as the match will last. It only depends on your level of stamina, endurance, or the level of fitness you have. But weak arms, it never happens.
Okay, we all have to try that out. Weak arms never happens. Take that. Take it from Judge. Quote him anywhere. Judge Malaika. It never happens, he says. Well, but of course, it's very true. Your ability to endure, your ability to persist, your ability to stay in the game gives that extra charge. And again, Udegbalam Ifunanya comes with the extra charge she puts to the fore for Anambra Queens as they crawl back from 3 points down. It's the only one they have to contend with now. Jersey number 9, Manafa Ngozi, made an error from his service once in this game. Uh-oh, was a poor touch. She wasn't ready for it. Jersey number 9, giveaway points number 9 to Bayonet Spikers. Smashing against their own net wouldn't do her team any good. Joseph Comfort. And they will. Take that point for their own bidding. And they say it took a tip, and it was another fault from Anambra Queens as they are now away by 4.
Quick substitution.
Peter Judith.
And she comes spiking. She comes picking up points.
Udegbala Ifunanya. Of course, one of the youngest discoveries of the tournament here. Talk about individual quality. She's got so much to build up for herself. And that could make her a huge force in the game.
This time, another 4 points deficit created for Anambra Queens,
and that's about what you talked about earlier in the game. But there is contention from the stands about the scoreline. I thought quite looked different at 9-7 at the time. A point was added to 10-7 in favor of Bayonet Spikers. Well, some felt it would have been 9-8. But But a number of Queens wouldn't even let that deter them.
Picking up another point to reduce the deficit.
Substitution, Bature Charity. That's what captains are made of. She leaves the court and quickly replaced already. Dagbala Ifunanya with a good service. A new entrant. And it goes out and they get a point and they are closer by two. They are playing catch up now. Anambra Queens haven't won the first set, 25-20. Oh, against our own net, and she regrets it. Jersey number 9 for the Queens.
Manafa Ngozi. Well, she's made some brilliant hits today, but counting about the other side, makes it for 3 hits. That's given away points to the opponent.
Thought it was long, but goalie bought. Rally still in progress. It's a good bump. The set follows. There's a spike to follow that. A tip to restore. And it was pushed to the other side. The spike comes in. And that one will win it. 11-13. And the Queens need 2 more again. Inside set number 2. Well, there will be an exhibition match today to be played for Gilberto Jiba Amori, who comes in the country. Well, he will have a team. Well, you look at that exhibition match and now you want to be able to put your mind to some speculations and you want to be like, who would you find in different teams? I mean, the His Honorable Minister, the Minister for Youth and Sport Development of the country, Chief Sunday Dare, will have a team, and Gilberto Amori will have a team. And then I want to ask the question, where is the team of the excellent President, President Musa Dibra, the excellent engineer? Where is his team? Doesn't he have a team here?
Well, I think he has a team. You could say his team is the team of the minister, because let's say, Jiba is in town, so Jiba is not his countryman. So he automatically belongs to the team of the minister. So he just gave the minister the honor to have a team. Hence, he is the one, Engineer Musa Nimro, he is the pioneer of all the teams. So it is quite honorable for him to allow the honorable minister to have a team by himself.
Well, it is honorable, but then you want to ask the questions. Are we going to be seeing the excellent engineer, President Musa Nimrod, in any of the teams as a player? Or are we going to be seeing him? Because he played in the days of Jiba. And if Jiba is going to be playing in this game, it totally means that we're surely looking forward to see him also take a part as someone who played in the same era. Wouldn't it be nice?
That would be nice, but that is going to happen. That is not going to happen. Engineer Musa Mura, you just enjoy the hosting. He's going to host everybody. He's going to control and make sure that everything is in his place. No problem, Mr. Engineer Musa Mura. I understand. Just make things happen.
I don't understand. Hold on. You are talking about him not bothering about that. A couple of people want to see the president play volleyball yet again. What about the excitement? I mean, you got to see him jump. You got to see him set. You got to see him spike. Wouldn't you want to talk about that?
That would be absolutely wonderful or a sight to behold, but I will still say, no, Engineer Musa Mura, just take your eyes water. Perhaps you could be one of the managers on the teams, but, oh, Engineer Musa Mura, don't play. Please don't play today.
Well, there is a divide in the commentary box about play or don't play. I want to see the president play. Get back to the game here. It's a deficit of 2 points now, an advantage of Bayonet Spikers, who are fighting for their first set in the game. It is the second set here, 15-13. The rally is still very much on, and it's for Anambra Queens to put it back in it, and they are back by 1 point, having won 1 point. 14-15, 29 rallies. We're just about to cross the midpoint of the game. We'll be timeout now for Bayonet Spikers, who will look to regroup. Coach Emmanuel Yahaya perhaps have got one or two to say to the girls. And we'll come back, or we'll continue. And maybe we'll talk about the president's position when he was playing. Well, we get back here. Well, maybe someone has got to pay some help. Maybe someone has got to actually bail us out. Maybe the president himself would like to bail us out by just being a part of that exhibition, and that would just settle it all. At least with that, we will have some questions being answered from time immemorial when he played to now. In the future, we'll also know about it, because this will be documented, wouldn't it? I mean, you watch the president play, he is tall, gigantic, he's got a very commanding posture. You can tell that he might be an outside hitter. But you wouldn't tell right now because you didn't play or didn't get to watch him play at the time. I didn't play or didn't get to watch him play as well. But of course, with him just playing, I think that settles it all.
Well, with him playing, that would be exciting, but in trying to anticipate or guess which position he has played during his own time of play, I wouldn't say that for sure. But during their own era, one thing I noticed is that all the tall guys are ruthless and brutal hitters. They hit the ball without mercy. I come across trying to know who has always been one of the greatest or much adorable player of volleyball, of mostly, let's say, an exceptional player. Like if you talk about people like Pele or Brazil, Diego Maradona, I get to stumble and come across one unbelievable player whose name is Jimmy George. They consider him as the god of volleyball. I tried to watch a few clips from that guy. He is absolutely brutal. Like I tell you, there has never been a time in the game of volleyball where you have weak hands. That guy will prove to you that there will never be a time a volleyball hitter will have weak hands. He continues to hit from the blast of the whistle till the end of the point. That guy is absolutely brutal. For those of you who watch recent volleyball, who always talk about Jiba, you talk about Gustavo, you talk about Leon, you talk about Nishida, you talk about Ngapet, you talk about Miseski and a host of others. But I tell you, if you go back and watch who Jimmy George is, an Indian for that matter, you will be left with your mouth wide open.
Well, of course, talk about occupational sports to becoming for Nigeria. You talk about India, Jimmy George, he doesn't sound Indian to me, but being an Indian, and in India, it is cricket considered their occupational sport. So it makes me wonder. It makes me wonder even more. And I'm beginning to ask questions. Well again, I'm beginning to wonder the height and the stand of the president, Musa Nimrod. I mean, he looks about 7'2", 7'3", and with a kind of a height as that, you'd expect him to also be brutal when it comes to hitting.
Yeah, during their era of engineer Musa Nimrod, I believe there are other players that I used to hear about. I hear about Coach Abdallah Usman, the coach of Kano Pillars. I hear about some other players like Tony Oguma. one-time technical chairman of the Nigerian Volleyball Federation. I hear also about there is this man they call Candido. There is another one called Coach Sam. All during all their era, I used to call them the era of the giant race. They are all so big and so tall. They don't care what hands are above the net to block them. They are in their own era. They have so much strength, so much power. They hit the ball without mercy.
You gotta be merciless to actually prove that you really want to take it. It's about how much you can hit it. How hard can you get? And in this game, the harder the better. Well, we will be anticipating that exhibition match, and hopefully we'll also be pleasured by the presence of the president if he gets to play. And taking you back to the game at hand, it is still the second set of it, and we are here with 18 points now being amassed by Anambra Queens, who also have a set lead here, respective of them trailing by his point in a second. And it is what it is. All you have to do is to put the God of Volleyball on Google and the name pops up. Jimmy George, who was born on March 8th, 1955 at Peravo, Kannur, Kerala, India. Well, he is late. He only lived for 32 years, sadly. Died on 30th November, 1987. In the province of Modena in Italy. Well, of course, it would be good to also check out the profile of our very own president, the excellent engineer. Oh, causing a stutter and puts them back to the game. An absolute spike, commanded enough to command applause from the spectators. It will be timeout. And Anambra Queens will gladly go to the bench with their shoulders high right now. Haven't gotten to the mark of 21st before Barnett Spikers, despite trailing for the most of the part of the game. Well, they lead here by a set and a point, 20-19. This is the second set. Well, jersey number 10, Jimmy George. Gets you back to the game here for the Queens. And it's a good block from Udagbala Ifunanya. And they now will take 1 point more ahead, 21-19. And Anambra Queens drop 1 point from the service. Talk about an unforced error. Some of the complaints so far in the game by the underdogs. Service not well orchestrated by Chukwuka Olubebe, and that one gives away a point as Bayonet Spikers are made to hit the point mark of 20. It's a good service. Set in play, Adeleke Blessing, and she will hit it well, perfectly.
It's 21 apiece in a second set. Anybody can absolutely actually take it. She continues to force out something real, and the point has been awarded to Anambra Queens. 22-21. Well, Anambra Queens did not start this set so well. They had to grow into it. They got to the point mark of 21st. They lead here 22-21. If they win this set, will it mean an easy ride in the third for them to make it a win of 3-0?
I'm going to expect that, but still the Bayonet seems to be very difficult to play because the Bayonet are also not sleeping. They are fighting very hard in every point that comes across to their court, but they eventually just keep losing. Even if Anambra Queens should win this set, it is not still going to be an easy one for them in the third set.
Meaning they have to still put up some energy. It's a question of two. Two is a set. Two is a difference. Two is a required for Anambra Queens to make it set number two, 23-21. And both teams are very cautious here now, making sure of not making mistakes, but that was a costly mistake. Manafan Gozzi smashes against her own net in a fashion she wouldn't even appreciate. And it's now 22-23 as Bayonet Spikers get a glimpse of hope. It's a good service. Bump to play by Fanaya. A push to the back court. And they will freely will be given a point that takes them closer to set number two. It's only now about a hit for two sets for Anambra Queens.
Well, you could say it's only a hit, but it might not be only a hit. Oh, and it is just a hit! You guessed that right, it is just a hit!
I said it, did I? And it's exactly what it is. 25-20, the first set wrapped up. 25-22, the second set has wrapped up, all in favor of the youngest side in the tournament. Anambra Queens are rising to the fore, believing and bowling and getting all the accolades. Bayonet will have to come back in the third with a better force if they have to stay alive in it.
Tell about Gilberto Amanzi Iba. Hold on. us. Thank you very much, and I wish you happy viewing. The match, Team Anambra is 2 games up, Major Count 2-0. Thank you very much.
It's 2-0 in favor of Anambra Queens. Good head, a good head there by the captain. She tried to give her team a hope right here. Joseph Comfort with the head. So serves, good serve. Couldn't get a strong hit on that pawn. Comfort also hits the ball again. She gets a brush out. Patient with the serve. She serves in. It was in. And Anambra Queens are beginning to lose concentration at the early stage of this set. Ibiriri Ife, patient. JC number 4 for Bayonet. Ifunaya crosses the ball without a spike. Comfort hits with the left hand. Ifunaya hits, she is sent back. The ball still in play. Ifunaya to cross the ball. Good hit. Comfort goes again, she hits out. Beg it pardon, that was Jonah Root. She hit. And Anambra Queens to serve now, 3-1 on the scoreboard. Is defended but couldn't keep it in play. Point to Bayonet. Ture Charity goes for the serve for Bayonet. Good serve, excellent dig. Ifunaya goes for the kill and she gets it. Diagbala Ifunanya. She is the force to reckon with in this match. As Joseph Comfort also tries to keep Bayonet afloat in this match. Good set. She didn't get the point. Ball still in play. Ifunanya crossed it. Oh, Comfort makes a point with the drop. It's Comfort Joseph now to serve for Bayonet. Anambra Queens need to take this set very seriously. Ojunwa couldn't get that point. The ball falls again. It is 6-2 on the scoreboard. Bayonet are leading. Joseph Comfort serves well. Ifunanya goes for the hitch and she gets the point. If the Anambra Queens really want to see themselves win this match, they need to be much more serious than what they are doing right now. Good serve by Ifunanya. Great set. That will be a point for the Bayonet. It is Adeleke Blessing that gets that point for Bayonet. Yes, Sandra Serra serves to the net. Onyize Chiamaka now to serve for Anambra Queens. She serves well. Comfort couldn't. Oh, she got an ace. Great serve. Chiamaka goes against the serve for Anambra Queens. Ifunanya goes for the hard kill. It was defended. Good set by the Bayonet setup. Retrieved. Ifunanya goes again with the off speed. It is defended. Great set again. Defended by Ifunanya. She just crossed the ball back to Bayonet for a kill. And that will be out. Point goes to Anambra Queens. They have reduced the score line to 1 point. Wunyize Chiamaka still serving for Anambra Queens. Excellent serve. Not so good reception. They have to give the ball back. The ball goes to Anambra Queens. Ifunanya goes for the kill, she didn't get it. Oh, the Anambra Queens have just leveled up the score line right now. It's 7-7 on the scoreboard. As Chiamaka continues to serve for Anambra Queens, the Bayonet Spikers need to be awakened. But said, she crosses the ball and she gets the point. That will be Adeleke Blessing right there that gets the point for Bayonet Spikers. Great serve. She almost got an 8. Send it back. Setter tries to set the ball. Give the ball back to Anambra Queens. Set the ball to Ojunwa. Ojunwa with the hit, but she couldn't get a point. Give the ball back to Anambra Queens. Ifunanya goes there with a drop and it was picked. The libero goes there for the set and the hit was out. Adeleke couldn't get this one for Bayonet. Ejogu Ojunwanan goes to serve for Anambra Queens. Good serve. She hit the ball but couldn't get the point. Manafa Ngozi couldn't get a good kill on that ball. The ball goes back to Anambra Queens. Ngozi again with the kill. Oh, Ngozi is right on net. It is a substitution for the Bayonet Spikers. JC number 11 make way. JC number 11 makes way for JC number 6, Peter Judith. She serves well. Ojun Ifunaya again with the serve. Ifunaya gets that hit right there in position one, and there was nobody there to defend that ball. This will be a huge plus for the Anambra Queens as Ifunaya steps into the front line of the court. Ball still in play. Oh, Ifunaya got the point again. It is 10-9 on the shot on the scoreboard. It is Manafa Ngozi that's to serve for Anambra Queens. Good pass by the libero. Anambra Queens makes a point again. It will be a first timeout call for the Bayonet Spikers. Welcome back. It is the Nigerian National Division 1 Volleyball League 2022 season. Ifunaya hits the ball out and the point goes to Bayonet. It is the Bayonet Spikers that are to serve right now. Good serve by the JC number 4. Bayonet gets the ball to spike. Joseph Comfort there with a point for Bayonet. Joseph Comfort has been very impressive in this match. She has been the one to make a whole lot of points for the Bayonet Spikers. Ifunaya goes out again. Joseph Comfort with the hit on the ball, but she didn't make a point. Ifunaya drops the ball, but it is picked. It's Ifunaya again in front. if Unaya gets the drop this time. That was brilliant. Udiagbala, if Unaya continue to lead the Anambra Queens to victory. It is 12 apiece on the scoreboard. Oh, Joseph Comfort couldn't get that. That was not a good set. Good serve. The ball is still in play. Joseph Comfort there. If Unaya goes for the kill and she gets it. Like I have said earlier on, it is a big plus for Anambra Queens while if Unaya is still in front line. Good serve right there and she gets an ace. Israel Bunam Cynthia continue to serve for Anambra Queens. Cynthia is right there on JC number 6. The ball is still in play. Oh, Cynthia got an ace again. Israel Bunam Cynthia with the serve. The serves across the net. It's a good dig. Sandra Serra right there coming up with the point for the Bayonet Spikers. But two charity serves for the Bayonet. It's if Unaya goes with the drop, but she didn't get the point. Comfort Joseph also didn't get the point. If Unaya tries to drop the ball is retrieved. Oh, Joseph Comfort hits the ball out. She hit the ball right on the antenna. A good reception. Jinwa tries to cross the ball. That will be a brush. The ball touches a player of the Anambra Queens. The point goes to Bayonet Spikers. It is Joseph Bature again with the serve for the Bayonet. If Unaya is sent back this time around, it is 15-17 on the scoreboard. The Bayonet Spikers continue to reduce the scoreline. Joseph Comfort right there with a serve. Joseph Comfort would get an ace. It will be a timeout call for Anambra Queens. It is worthy of note at this juncture that they need this timeout. You are welcome back from this timeout. It is still Joseph. Come for still serve and get the ball back to her court. The ball is still alive. Ifunaya goes with a soft hit. Ifunaya again gets the kill and she gets it perfectly well. Ifunaya now goes to serve. There is a little bit minus for the Anambra Queens right now. Ifunaya has gone back. Ifunaya has the serve. She served good. Joseph Comfort received nicely. The ball still in play. Ifunaya keep it afloat. Oh. Sandra Serra there with the points for Bayonet Spikers. It is 17-18 on the scoreboard. Anambra Queens still lead with 1 point. It is 2 point lead now, 19-17. Anambra Queens serve. She got an ace. It's 20-17 on the shot on the scoreboard. Onyize Chiamaka again. Onyize Chiamaka serves. Ball well received. Ifunaya defends that. Oh, Ojinwa just make that point. Ejiogu, Ojinwa, and Jason number 10 for Anambra Queens. She makes that point. Yeah, Anambra Queens coach is patiently waiting. He can't wait to see his team win this set to get done with this match. Ifunaya goes for the hit and she didn't get it. Jonah Root there come serve for the Bayonet. Ujinwa gets to hit the ball, but she didn't make the point. The ball goes to Ifunaya. Ifunaya drops the ball, but it was picked. Joseph Comfort there with the hit. Oh, that will be a brilliant point. Manafa Ngozi right there. It's 22-18 on the scoreboard. Anambra Queens are closer to win this match. Joseph, but Comfort crosses the ball. Anambra Queen hit again. Oh, the ball goes back and it is out. 23-18 on the scoreboard. Oh, heading for. They need to block two balls and they are there with the victory for this match. Oh, it was a good ball. The line judge says it's in. It's 19th scoreboard. Adeleke Blessings goes to serve for Bayonet. Ifunaya, the libero right there for reception. She gets an 8 again. Adeleke is still serving for Bayonet. She serves it to the other side. Oh, the ball is given back to Anambra Queens. just. That will be a timeout call for the Anambra Queens. They must have been putting the call. Welcome back. It is a match between Bayonet Spikers and Anambra Queens. Good serve by Adeleke. Ifunaya goes for the hit. She didn't get it. Before tries to drop the ball. The ball has been sent back to the Bayonet. Joseph Comfort goes for the drop. She didn't get it again. Ifunaya trusts the ball back. Joseph Comfort again will go for the kill. And she gets it. It is 22-23. Adeleke is still serving for Bayonet. Oh, she serves the ball right under the net. This will give the Anambra Queens a chance to be on mark, and Ifunaya is in front court. All they need to do is to serve the ball across the net. This could be a moment they have been waiting for. Good serve right there. The setter goes to Joseph Comfort. Joseph Comfort hit hard and she gets it. It's 23-24 on the scoreboard. Ifunaya is in front. And Bayonet on JC number 10, Jonah Root, is to serve. She serves the ball very effectively. Ifunaya gets the ball. Ifunaya gives the ball back. Ifunaya hits the ball and they defense it. Ifunaya again with the hit. She is blocked. She sent the ball back to the court and the ball is still on. Ifunaya goes for the kill. She goes for a drop. Ifunaya goes for the kill and she gets it. It is all over. It's all over. The Anambra Queens just win their first match in this championship. It is the Nigerian National Division 1 Volleyball League 2022 season right here in MK Abiola National Stadium in Abuja, Nigeria's capital. I am your host in the commentary box, Malaika George. This is the end of this match. See you soon.